And Klo gets it. To the line, a shot by Green. Saved by Halak. And then another save on Ryder by Halak.
Got his blocker on it.
Net is empty. Pearvey gloves it to Lapierre. And at the empty net, and he scores!
And there's a scratch behind the play.
That's Pollock involved with Ryan Klo. Oh, boy.
I think Klo might have got him underneath. And then respectfully stops the bout because Roman Pollock was in a bad spot. Empty net goal by Max Lapierre. Off the good play by Magnus Pearvey with no stick. Pearvey swats it with his glove. Roman Pollock, not a happy check as he goes off. Happy about the win, not happy about the scrap afterwards. Again, New Jersey can't score for their goalie. At the other end, Jaro Halak. Something you don't see very often. A straight-ahead poke check there by this Slovak that will be going to the Olympics again. And then there's a scrap right here, and this uppercut right here by Klo knocks Roman down. Klo stops the scrap. That's all she wrote.
But the empty netter by Lapierre is seventh. And the Blues lead 3-0. And some sweet revenge for the Blues after last week's 7-1 loss in Jersey. And this goes down the ice. Schneider looks to move it. Gets it by Brendan Borum.
Score by number 40, Maxime Lapierre.
The Blues entering play tonight. 1 point behind Chicago with three games in hand. As the Blackhawks in Calgary tonight.
And 5 games left now before the break. And Ken Hitchcock not afraid to say before this game, 6 games left, focus on the 6. Let's catch Chicago. Let's be the division leaders heading into the Olympic break.
Pearvey and Bergman get the assist on the goal by Lapierre. And a drive by Carter wide. And kept in by Volchenkov. And now Morrow battles in the corner. There's Carter spinning off Petrangelo's check. To Bernier, one-timer, blocked by Bouwmeester. And now Bouwmeester will settle it. And with a minute to go in this game, he gets it out. And Lapierre at the bench. Now Stewart goes after Bernier, and he gives him a couple of rights after Bernier had taken a shot at a Blues player, I think Morrow. And Stewart's right in the middle of that. And we get bodies flying everywhere here.
It was actually Bernier gave Lapierre a really dangerous shot here along the boards, and that's why Stewart came in, guys.
Two former members of the Vancouver Canucks. Everybody okay down there, Bernie?
Everybody's fine.
Looked like Shattenkirk was motioning towards somebody with...
Everybody is... Lapierre's at the bottom of the pile here, but he looks like he's okay here.
Looks like Bernier still shoving away, though, at it. Remember when the Blues had that offer sheet to Bernier? After the Vancouver Canucks had that offer sheet to Backes? So a little bit of push right there against Carter. Bernier goes in and gives him a cross check from behind. Stewart's right there, so he goes right in. To make sure he takes care of that. Carter then in Backes wrapped up. Lapierre comes over and gets a stinky leather mitt over Bernier.
And good for Stewart to jump in there.
Absolutely, John. Absolutely.
Congratulations to Ken Hitchcock here. Most wins, Blues coach all time. There's Coach Q with 307, Brian Sutter, Andy Murray, Scotty Bowman, and this will be Ken Hitchcock's 108th victory with the St. Louis Blues.
Yes, a couple of games ago, he tied Jacques Demers with 106, and now with the last two wins at 108. And the legendary Bowman is next on his list as far as Blues wins. So all of this with 49 seconds left in the third period. And the Blues about to win their 36th game of the year.
And you know what? The Jersey Devils are going to have a power play. And that's the shame about this, because the original shot, and you know, it's hard for the referees to see that, but the original shot was the Bernier push on Lapierre, which should have been a penalty. Now, the retaliation was Stewart, and that's where the extra two is coming. So it's kind of a shame that that's the only one was seen.
Well, Lapierre's first whack was on Carter. And Bernie.
Yeah.
And then Bernie went over and gave a.
Yeah, and it was a real dangerous cross check from behind too, though, Panger. Wow.
Yeah. And the Blues win the faceoff and chip it out. Devils 0-for-3 in the power play. And 5 shots total. And now in the final 30 seconds, Zubers gets in there. In front. And then turned away by Shattenkirk with a good play. And he gets it all the way down the ice.
The former Pee Wee New Jersey Devil player, Kevin Shattenkirk.
Here comes Josephson, drops it off. Sobotka hoists it the other way. And under 12 to go. As Jarohalak about to pick up another shutout. Has 19 in his Blues career. And he gets another one as the Blues win it 3-0.
And he got some help from that guy, Barrett Jackman, who had a heck of a game defending as well. Jackman did a good job down below, especially against Jagr. Steen scores the first goal of the game, which ends up being the game winner. Morrow scores a key power play goal to make it 2-0. But Jaroslav Halak, the difference in goal. And he has got himself on a roll. Rumors? What rumors?
It is 20th shutout as a Blue. That is the Blues' all-time record. Now 4 ahead of Mr. Goalie Glenn Hall. And Steen gets the game winner. His team leading 7th game-winning goal.
Yeah, but crack went open for Jaroslav Halak. And it's a nice cold Bud Light. Faced 23 shots, made 23 saves, his 29th career shutout, and his 20th with the Blues, as you mentioned, John Kelly.
Let's go down to Tom Calhoun.
Here's of tonight's game. The game's third star, scoring one goal and playing at a forward for the Blues, number 20, Alexander Steen. The game's second star, scoring one goal, playing at a forward for the Blues, number 10, Brendan Morrow. And the game's first star, stopping all 23 New Jersey shots, playing in goal for the Blues, number 41, Jaroslav.
Yes, indeed. The first star of the game, Yarrow, 23 saves, your 20th career shutout. Now, how good does this feel after especially what happened last week in New Jersey, losing the game 7-1?
Yeah, it was really a strange game. When we played there, it seemed like every team went in, everything they touched, it was a scoring chance. But tonight, I think we did a really good job. We knew we had to play so much better, especially on the PK. Last game, they went 3-4-4, and we knew we just had to be better at that part of the game, and we were.
You talked about the PK, 4-for-4 tonight, but right off the bat, 9 seconds into the game, you guys had to kill a penalty, and it seemed there was an awful lot of blocked shots that helped you out in that first penalty kill.
Yeah, it was a lot of weird bounces at the beginning of the game. You know, the first one when Roman took the penalty, all the boards, and then on their power play, they had a lot of chances, but guys were great blocking the shots, and we were able to get through that one.
How hard is it for a goaltender? You know, it's a 1-0 game. There's a lot of push. It was Jersey coming. How important was that second goal for you guys to get in the middle of the third?
Oh, it was huge. You know, Mo, he's great at tipping the pucks. He always does it in a practice, and he done it again tonight. It was a huge goal for us, and I think if we wouldn't score that goal, it could have been a little bit different.
And for you, this is your 4th win in a row. You're feeling very good. It looks like you're really seeing the puck well. You seem to be at the top of your game right now.
Yeah, I mean, I feel good, but I always say it's a team game, you know. Guys were blocking the shots. Without them, I wouldn't be able to get a shot out, and we wouldn't be able to get a win. So I always say we need 20-plus guys to win the game.
Thanks, Yara. Congratulations on the shutout and the big win.
Thanks.
That's shutout number 29 in his career, Pat, as we send it upstairs to you.
Absolutely right, Bernie. Number one star, 29th career shutout, 20th as a Blue, and fourth of the season. As Bernie mentioned as well, Yaroslav Halak winning his last four starts. And the Blues, well, they played the kind of game they had to play against the Devils. It may not have been a thing of beauty, but in the end, those two third-period goals putting it away in a 3-0 shutout over those New Jersey Devils. Don't forget, Missouri Lottery Blues Live, the post-game edition just around the corner. Keep it here on your home of the Blues, Fox Sports Midwest.